start off, I'm a 23-year-old male. I had just had my schedule changed to the night shift as part of a new project that couldn't be done during normal business hours. It was a project that consisted of my coworker, James, and me working alone to completely revamp 14,000 locations. Working the night shift was pretty badass. We would work really hard for the first few hours and get the scheduled work done. Then we could just bullshit for the last few hours. We spent most of the night binging on YouTube videos, Netflix, and taking as many smoke breaks as we felt like. There was an eerie feeling at times, being in such a large building that has over 3,000 employees working during the day, and we were only two people there at night, other than a lazy security guard that we would see every few days or so. So to get down to the nitty-gritty part of the story, one night we were in the bullshit portion of our shift. It was around 10:30 at night. We were sitting on our computers watching an episode of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia when we started to hear an odd noise. Now, at night, when the conveyor was off, no forklifts were being driven around, noises would echo, and you could hear things that you normally wouldn't be able to. So the noise we heard was like a ruffling sound, about 100 feet away. We both gave it a quick glance, but didn't think much of it, and soon after, we went back to our show. Over the next hour or so, we continued to hear sounds coming from the same area. We started to get a tad concerned, but more annoyed, and we had to keep pausing the show to listen. The area the noise was coming from was a section of 50 stand-up freezers in three rows. We decided to go check it out. Together, of course. Armed with our box cutters and steel-toe boots, we made our way to the first row. At this time, we were no longer hearing the sounds we heard before. We then made our way to the middle row. Turned a corner and a chill ran down my spine.
Did you see that?
No, what are you talking about?
I went on to explain to James that I had seen something move very quickly down the end of the aisle. By the time I seen it, it was already pretty much gone. Whatever it was had made its way to aisle 3. Aisle 3 was mainly used for storage, basically a place to store stuff we called out of sight, out of mind materials. Needless to say, it wasn't the most organized area in the whole warehouse. At this point, I wanted to get the hell out of there, but James just called me a pussy and started to proceed to the end of the aisle. Hesitating at first, I decided to follow. Then we heard it. The sound of scraping metal back and forth coming from aisle 3, directly on the other side of where we were standing. I slowly walked to the freezer, and the sound stopped. I looked through the crack between the two freezers, and what I saw still haunts me till today. One bloodshot eye staring right back at me. I jumped back in fear, and in utter panic. I turned around to run, knocking James over in the process. I sprinted all the way back to the desk before I had the courage to turn around. James was about halfway to the desk at this point. We both looked at each other without saying a word and agreed it was time to leave. The next day, I came into work still shook. I went to go check the area during the day when everyone was still at work. I found a plastic bag of dirty clothes and a rusty screwdriver, along with a bottle that I can only imagine was piss. Turns out a homeless man had been sneaking into the building through a slightly damaged bay door at night, and he had been sleeping there for weeks.